Taylor.
Yeah, baby.
Let him know what's up, Dan.
Taylor, what's up, bro? What's going on, man? How you doing tonight,
how you doing,
man?
Brother? You good? Good.
I'm doing excellent, man.
Is it cool if I take the face mask off?
Yeah. You're fine.
It's all good.
It's all good, man.
Bro, I got well. First off, I got my boy over here. We'll get over here. Let's go, boys. Want a VMA? My boy just
won a VMA. Let's go. VMAs. Let's go.
Okay. Fresh off a VMA win right now.
What'd you win?
Woo!
Yeah, best song to alternative, baby. Let's go.
What was the song?
Hey. Bloody Valentine.
Bloody Valentine.
Okay, that's dope.
Bloody Valentine, baby. Let's go.
Bloody Valentine. Yeah. She got Kelly Travis Barker, my son.
Yeah.
Bro, yeah, baby, we did that.
Let's go, baby.
Hey, I swear, I saw you on TV today.
That's
hard,
this guy.
That was you. That was you.
Yeah.
So explain to me what's going on, man. You guys are out here partying, celebrating tonight?
Tonight? Well, we're not partying, but we're celebrating a win. That's what we're doing. Celebrating a big win.
That's good.
Yes.
That's good. So what else has been going on with you?
A lot of stuff. Been in the news a lot. Been doing a lot of my own stuff. Got a bunch of stuff coming up with MadCon, which is very huge, which I'm very excited about.
But okay. Yeah. Okay, dude. What's going on with MadCon?
Right now with MadCon, we're trying to get a MadCon house. So we're trying to get as many people as we can together to do a MadCon house.
Okay, I like
that. But it's taking a lot of steps, but we want to do it right, not like the other way other people did. But one thing people need to understand about MadCon is we kind of paved the way.
Right.
For kids that are coming up and doing what they're doing, they kind of took our whole damn flow. So like,
right.
You know what I'm saying? We paved the way to be able to do it. So now we're about to come in and do our thing now.
Okay, and I remember you guys' old show on Netflix, with Cameron. Are you still cool with Cameron?
Cameron's still one of my very good friends. He's doing his thing. He went off to rehab twice now.
Oh wow,
and
I didn't know that.
Got his stuff together and he's doing way better than he was before, and I'm happy.
Really? What got to him? I didn't know that he was in rehab.
I think it was just like alcohol, a lot of alcohol.
Okay.
And just mainly sexual intercourse. He's talked a lot about it.
Really?
And yeah, so it's out there, people know about it, but yeah.
Okay.
He dealt with that for a while.
What do you think about his new girlfriend, Madison?
Madison, she's beautiful. Like, it's literally helped change his life, so it's like been good for him. I've been like noticing a lot of changes with him. He's like, his character is way better now.
Yeah.
And I think she's honestly changed his life a
lot. That's good. I was shooting the other day and somebody said something about propose to her and he almost proposed to her on the spot.
So, I don't know about that. I don't know if he should get married yet. I think he needs to take it slower, but maybe he might get married.
We tried to get him to do it, but he almost did it. But
no.
So I also hear that you had some drama with like Keemstar. What's going on with that?
All right, man. Keemstar has been coming at me since I was, let's say I was about 18 years old. Since Keemstar has started, he's covered me every single time. I can't tweet anything. I can't say anything. He's always, it don't matter what I do. I'm not even super relevant, but it seems that I am sort of relevant because everything I tweet, I get a reaction out of. So basically, I just tweeted like, hey, you know, like people that, you know, have been invited to the house parties in Hollywood are the same people that aren't invited. Which was a funny tweet to me, like I'm in Cabo, like Mexico, right?
Right.
Just laughing. And he makes like a whole video on me on Twitter and then puts me in a whole segment on his YouTube channel. And I was like, okay. So then I texted him and I was like, yo, like, try to. And I was like, yo, man, like, I thought we were cool, and then he was like, da da da, but it's, when I see Keemstar, it's on site.
Really?
Yeah.
Okay, wow, yes. So you better watch out.
Well, the thing is, what was crazy is me is I wasn't even at the parties, but his business partner, Banks, is at the parties.
Right.
So I was like, oh, you're coming to me, but your business partners are actually at the parties. So
right.
It's like,
that was kind of odd. So, okay, yeah. So what exactly did he, so he was like trying to say something bad about you?
No, basically he said that he was like, these idiots out in LA, these influencers that are going to these house parties. One, I haven't been at these house parties. Two, your business partners are actually at these house parties. And three, you're coming at me. So then when I fired back, my manager was like, you need to delete that.
Okay.
But it did very well. My tweet back to him did way better than his tweet towards me. So.
Okay, and then Tyler Oakley's had had your name in his mouth a lot too recently.
Yes, for like the last 6 years he's had his name in my mouth.
Really? What's he got? What problems has he got with you?
I tweeted back to him, but like my publicist obviously deleted it later on, was like, yo, just don't respond to anything right now. But basically I just said like, yo, you've had my name in your mouth for like the last 7 years. If you want to talk it out, let's go on a date.
Okay.
So I told him, I said, let's go on a date, man. Like, let's go on a date. Let's figure it out.
Date?
So I told him, go on a date, yeah.
Okay.
Yes.
And what's going on with you and Bryce Hall, man? I heard some people were saying that you thought he was kind of like copying your style.
Oh, he has kind of took my whole flow. Like,
okay.
I was the first person out in Hollywood to fully party, whatever. Rice Gum brought us up in a video for me, hooked up with his ex-girlfriend, like all that went on. But we were cool now, but obviously the kid's got to watch what he's doing. I know he's got a couple of lawsuits definitely coming his way.
Wow.
A few punching some little kids in the face and shit, but
really?
a couple of them.
Who did he punch in the face?
I can't say the kid's name, but it's gonna be out there.
So he punched some kids in the face.
Oh, he punched a very young, like young kid with a very wealthy family in the face.
Oh,
kid.
Really?
Yes.
Wow. Okay, I've been hearing different things going on, but never really known exactly what was going on. So what about Nick Austin though?
Nick Austin's my brother. I love the kid. He's great. I was with them last night, so it's up to him to Madison. Right. Hope they're doing well. But
yeah, you
that's
guys were at Saddle Ranch. I saw you at Saddle Ranch. I was trying to get at you, but there were so many people.
There were so many people there.
You couldn't hear me. I was trying to get your attention. So what? Okay, so
I love Nick Austin. I love Nick Austin, but Nick Bean. That's why I got started up. Nick Bean was really drunk on my friend's phone. They're on, I guess what you would call live, and I grabbed the phone. I was like, "Yo, man. Yo, Nick, go to sleep. Like, you're fucked up." I was like, "Yo, you gotta take a nap, bro. You're drunk." And he was like, "Ah, da, da, da." We went back and forth, and I was like, "Yo," and he brought up the Tony Lopez situation, and I was just like, "Yo, I don't know enough, but like, I know like."
What do you think about Tony Lopez?
Man, I was like, I think I was one of like the first kids on the internet to ever be canceled for mistakes that I made when I was younger.
Right.
But I was never 20 to 25 years old when I made those mistakes. And I made those mistakes, I was like 14 to 13 years old. I feel like when you're mature, you should kind of know what you're doing.
Right.
So I can't really speak on the justice. Like, I don't think there's anything you can do to fix that. I don't know if there's anything you can or try to do. That's something I don't stick for. Is like, I don't think it's full pedophilia, but I think it's like kind of like.
Okay.
You shouldn't be hitting up 16-year-old girls if you're 20. All
right. That's true. You got a point there. Okay. I can't argue with you on that one.
That's basically it with me with that.
Okay. So what else are you working on, man? I got to end up taking off, man. Give me like one last note for your fans. Like,
the biggest thing I'm going to tell you right now is get ready for MadCon.
Okay, MadCon. All right. That's what's up, man. Hey, good seeing you tonight, man.
Good seeing you, man.
All right. Take care, bro.
Appreciate it.
Have a good night. Appreciate you too, man. Good seeing you.